Hey everyone, breakfast vlog for Wednesday the 23rd of October 2019. What a beautiful day we got moving on here. You know, a little bit of cloud over there on the left hand side you can see just coming over the mountain. That's coming from the west. I'm pointing, the camera's pointing almost, you know, westish. And that should be coming, a little bit of cloud later on today, but it's supposed to be a really nice day. So anyway, a little crisp. Got down to about 2 degrees last night, but hey man. That's just the way it is here in the Kootenays. In winter's coming, you can't avoid it. Here I was hoping for all that global warming. Yeah, okay, whatever. I'm being an ass. Anyway, holy crap. First things first, thank you. I don't know what happened. Maybe it was the Hillary video. I don't know. I did the Trump video too. I know it's terrible. But I felt I had to do a Trump video as well as a Hillary video because of the shenanigans with Tulsi and all that. But I didn't know what to do about Trump, so I just threw one together. And I know it's shit, so sorry. But anyway, it is what it is. I got 10 new subscribers like over the last couple days, so I'm really happy. So I guess my echo chamber must have got out. BitChute, that video got lots of views on lots, sorry. It got double the views at YouTube on BitChute, so I'm pretty happy about that. But, you know, I thought it was pretty funny because, I mean, really, you know, that's why I know that all of this is a game, or I feel that all this is a game, because, you know, anybody who seems to get in Clinton's way seems to have a problematic life or something going on. But, you know, so Tulsi better be doing some podium stuff like, you know, like, wasn't that Eddie Murphy talking about the first black president, you know, on the podium or something? I can't remember, comedian, you know. Tulsi better get her cardio up, because she needs to be stopped. I don't think she should stand in one place for more than a nanosecond. She should always be moving. And don't let any flags be blowing next to you, okay? You don't want to have any flags. You know, you don't want to get any ideas which way the wind's going, right? Anyway. Thank you to new and old. I see I got 10 more. I'm really happy about that. It'd be really great to get to 1,000. Woo! Get to 1,000. I think I might have a heart attack and die. But that's not what I want to talk about this morning. I'm doing some help. I'm doing some work on a house, an old house with a buddy of mine. He bought the house and, you know, he's renovating. We're doing the crawl space and we're doing the attic. Anyway, he calls me and says, hey man, yeah, you gotta get some stuff out of the attic. I guess the last people over here didn't take some stuff and they'd stored some stuff up in the attic. So we go up in the attic and we're like, wow, we're going through the attic, and it's obviously not the people who had lived there before, because they were like young kids, you know, and all this stuff is old. And look what I score. In the attic, I find a whole bunch of these. A whole bunch, about a dozen. For me, that's a whole bunch. Now, I just started reading this one. I got this one too. Here, I wanted to show you this one. This one's kind of, I found it funny because it's right at the end of the war, right? And there's the American soldier. Now, I don't think he is giving the Nazi salute. I think he's just probably waving at some buddies. He's got his hand up, and I don't know, which hand did we use in the Nazi? Was it your right hand? I don't know. I don't know which one it is, so, but Life magazine, I love the back, eh? All the backs of the Life magazines have the cigarette commercial, the cigarette ads. Oh, it's amazing. Anyway, so I wanted to just go through, like this one here, I'm scared of the thing falling apart. This one's got the article about when they're taking the magnifying glass at the Palomar Observatory in California, I believe. 19 years work and blah 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 blah, Mount Wilson in Southern California, and here's the picture of the truck taking the, I'm sure you can get this online, but you know, so I started reading through this book this morning, and holy cow man, the ads and the stuff that's in here. Like, it's right after, all these books that I got are pretty well right around the war, right after the war. I think I got some from 1939. Like, look at this, man. Like, I didn't even know this stuff existed. The Chinese War Memorial. That's where the Japanese came through China. I just read the article. Now, okay. Is this real or true? I don't know, man. I have to vet it. But, you know, it's Life magazine, right? So the Japanese went through and just killed a whole bunch of Chinese. So I imagine in the Chinese, the Chinese don't forget. So I imagine that's still pretty up in their minds. But I noticed something else in this one here. I was reading through it. I don't want to fold this too hard. Counting noses. At Flushing Meadow balloting on the Palestinian issue brought two men to their feet for a tense count of votes. Secretary General Tirgiv Lai, or Lee, left, and his assistant Andrew Cordier. The vote 33-13 to split Palestine into Arab and Jewish states. That's that one right there. Now, last time I heard, split means split. So, I don't know. Anyway, it seems to not be that way anyway. Here's a good one, okay? Obviously, she's a professional skier or something, or back in the day. So she's advertising the cigarette and everything. And oh, I love this one, man. It actually has an ad in here where you give your wife utensils for Christmas. Because this one's around a Christmas issue. Yeah, it's December 8th, right? So it's a Christmas issue. Where's that? I want to see that ad. I should have marked it for you guys. You know, some of them are just so funny. The ads, the cigarette ads, the goop ads, the for your hair, you know. Oh, man. Anyway, what can I tell you? Give her a set of, you know. Oh, yeah, here you go. It's not the dishes. It's Christmas. Give her the subtle flattery of sheets in personality colors. Wow. If I bought my girlfriend sheets or dish stuff or like a Christmas present or something, I think I'd be just killed right there on the doorstep. Or I think I'd be buried under the Christmas tree. But holy crap. Anyway, I'm just looking at that stuff and I gotta read through all of it. I mean, it is Life Magazine, and I believe that, you know, I don't know much about Life Magazine. I know it's been around a long time. We checked online. Those aren't really worth much money. I think they're worth about $20. You have to have, like, Elvis or, you know, something. I've got one of the fat guy who smoked cigars in World War II. Winston Churchill. I got him. I've got this Duke of Windsor. I don't know who he is. The Duke of Windsor. A couple others. You know, there's one. It's just generic pictures. You know, three planes over England, 1939. Stuff like that. But just reading through the articles and the stuff, and the remedies, the cold medicines. It's really cool. I mean, in another 20 years, those books will be 100 years old, right? Or those magazines. And as far as I can tell, they're real. Like, they were in an attic, tucked away in the back in the corner somewhere, and I just pulled a sheet away, and I was like, ah! You know, I've got a, you know, stack of them. Some of them are all ripped up, like the covers are gone, so somebody probably tore the cover off, so I have, like, you know, 12 that are good, and maybe the rest that are all just pieces. But what I'm going to do for the pieced ones is I'm going to cut out all the cigarette commercial things, like, you know, lauding cigarettes and... all our doctors smoke Camels, you know, and it's just, I love it. I just love it, absolutely love it. I mean, I don't care. I love the days of everybody smoking in the plane and smoking in the airports, and I could care less. When I go to Ecuador, I'm back in time when I go down there and people are drinking beer in the street and smoking a cigarette in the restaurant and... Nobody dies, you know? Anyway, I don't know. I'm sure there are some people that it probably affects, but for me, you know, the person next to me says, do you mind if I smoke while you're eating? Have two. I could care less, you know? It doesn't ruin my meal. But anyway, I digress. But oh boy, I gotta go through all those magazines. It'd be gonna be interesting to read, though. Just a little snippet on the election. Oh, as I roll my eyes. What can I tell you? Liberals got in again. I'm really quite surprised, actually. You know, I voted. Everybody in town here, it was a big turnout for us here in the cusp, I believe. You know, that it's the hockey arena, right? So you sit there for 5 minutes and you know, people coming in and out, you're seeing half the town population. So I'm pretty sure that a lot of people did vote. Yes, some people didn't vote, and that's fine. But you're not going to, because I'm not a liberal where I used to be, but I've switched over to conservative, but now I'm more of a liberal or a conservative NDPer, because our guy in this riding here, the fellow who's here, Richard Cannings, I believe his last name is, Cannings, I always screw that up. He's an NDPer, but he does very well for this community. He does good things for us here in this riding, so it's a strong... Nobody's had any problems with this guy, so, and he's not that bad. So I voted for him, but I'm not going to sit here like, you know, or, you know, like, why, you know, that Trudeau got in, or, you know, standing up in the street with, he's not my prime minister, you know. I'm Canadian and I'm military trained, so I don't practice democracy. I enforce it, or I just, you know, he's elected. I'm not happy, but I'll respect the results and I'll go with that. You know, what are we all going to just get our shotguns and go to Ottawa? You know, that's not going to work. And I'm surprised he got in. He has a minor government now. He has a minority government. So it's going to be tricky on how things are going to work and how things are going to go forward. It's just the way it goes, right? So, you know, now we've got to, they're going to have, well, you know, there's possibility that there is some good coming out of this, because now there has to be dialogue. If you've got a minority government, you have to have dialogue and you have to have other parties on board in order for you to push your agendas forward, or your ideas, whatever, you know. But with anything, I hope that the stupid stuff, like him, like Trudeau saying, like, yeah, I'm going to make the internet hate-free in Canada. Well, it's bad enough already in Okanukistan. So don't do us any favors, old Justy. Old Justy, don't. Just do your thing. Go and take selfies for the next 4 years. Do some blackface, you know. Go to Montreal Canadiens game. Just keep your mouth shut. That'd probably be the best thing to do, is just keep your mouth shut. Because you just, you know, anyway. But like I said, another 4 years, we'll see how it goes. But Justin's back in. And a lot of people are like, what? You know, they're like, what the heck happened, you know? But there again, I think Canadians aren't really, like, when we saw that stuff about Justin before, and, like, you know, him in his Aladdin suit, which is not blackface. Al Jolson blackface. You know, big lips, circled eyes. For somebody to camo up and change the color of face is not blackface. Minstrel shows, you know, like, that's, they've switched the definition. They've mashed that if you do any kind of change, it's blackface. But that's not what blackface is. But I, of course, I don't agree with blackface. I mean, it's pretty sad. But, you know, anyway, Justin, it is what it is, right? So, anyway, I'm rambling. Thank you, the new subscribers. I really appreciate it. I'm going to go through all these Life magazines. I'm going to find, you know, if anything I see that's cool, I'm going to start reading through them, and I'll just bring it up, read it, and we'll do some stuff with the Life magazines, because I think those are pretty cool. I just started reading through this Duke of Windsor guy. You know, that's a long time ago. I don't know any about that stuff. You know, some of the articles are pretty funny, too, so, you know. And ads are just classic. I love the ads, you know. The AC, AM, Philco or Delco radio for your car, you know, with the foot pedal change station button. Like, wow. I'm surprised we made it, you know. Anyway, I digress, like I said. Take care. Peace to you and yours. Hope to see you on the flip side.